Okay, we're starting with that Hashem Daf Samech Aleph. The Gemara says that Amar Ula, top of the page. Amen. Sa'ir. If you have this Sa'ir, Sa'ir Lashem, Sheshahato, that you slaughtered it, Kodem Matan Damo Shel Par, before you sprinkle the blood of the par, Lo Asav, Lo Klum, he didn't do anything. Why? Because the Chiluk HaSedeh, and Mestama, like we said before, even like the Biudah, that holds that the stuff that you do, the Bigdei Lavan, out of the Kodesh HaKodashim, the Seder is the Ma'akev, but Shechitat HaSa'ir, since it's L'tzorech Benim, is Kir Lufnim Damit. Amar Ula, Sa'ir Sheshechato Kodim Matan Damo Shopar, Lo Asav Lokum. Tenam, we learn, Ekdim Dama Sa'ir L'dama Par. If he did the Dama Sa'ir before the Dama Par, Yahazor v'yazem midama sa'ir. Let him go back and sprinkle from the dama sa'ir. Echad dama par, ahar dama par. After you do the dama par. So how is it possible if you sprinkle the dama sa'ir before you sprinkle the dama par, it also means that you will shohet the sa'ir before you did the hazaot of the dama par. Which Ula says, sa'ir sheshahato kodim matan damo shopar v'lo asav v'lo klum. Yet the Mishnah says the opposite. The Mishnah says that if you sprinkle the Dama Sa'ir before the Dama Par, what do you have to do? Just go back and re-sprinkle the Dama Sa'ir. Because the Hazaot that you did out of order before the Dama Par weren't good. So redo the Hazaot. But the Mishnah doesn't seem to imply that the Shechitat HaPar, the Shechitat HaSa'ir is not good, because it just says Yahzov Yazeh. And it doesn't say Yahazor.
I thought it was necessarily something that impedes the actual avodah in the Kodesh.
Shechita.
Yeah, but that doesn't actually impede the.
Of course it does.
No, that doesn't do anything because I just have two sets of blood. It has to be in order that I can't mess up the inside.
What we said is tzorech pnim, something that's done that affects the inside. That's ma'akev the inside. You can't. It's also considered like it's inside. So the shechitat sa'id without sa'id, there's no blood. So that has to be in order. The order of that is that after the hazah of the par. So that's what Ula says. He says ma'akev. But the problem is Al Mishnah is against that, because Al Mishnah says that if you did the sa'id. Al Mishnah says, if you did the Hazah of the Sa'ir before the Hazah of the Par, just do the Hazah of the Sa'ir again. What do you mean? If you did the Hazah of the Sa'ir before the Hazah of the Par, it means you did the Shechitah of the Sa'ir before the Hazah of the Par. And the Shechitah of the Sa'ir, according to Ula, before the Hazah of the Par is Pasul. Says the Gemara, Tirgema Ula b'matanot shebe'echal. Ula explains it that it's not talking about the matanot in the Kodesh HaKodeshim, which is Me'akev. And which happens, meaning, if you did it in the matanot shebehechal shebekodesh kodeshim, so when you slaughter the sa'ir after the hazaot of the par, so the shechita is part of the order. Mashenkin in the matanot of the echal, the shechita already happened by the hazaot of the kodesh kodeshim, which we're assuming you did correctly. And what are we talking about now? We're talking about the hazaot in the echal. So he came out of the kodesh kodeshim. He did the sa'ir before the echal. Before he put it down, he did it. Doesn't count. But the shechita is already good. Masha'enken in the Kodesh Kodashim, if you did the hazaot of the sa'ir before the hazaot of the party, right. Go make another shechita. Your shechita is possible. Tergema ula b'matanot shebe'echal. V'chen amar b'yafas. Rabbi Yafas also said the same. B'matanot shebe'echal. It's talking about the matanot in the echal. V'chem, Rabbi Afas is a student of Rabbi, so if Rabbi Afas is telling you the way, you know, it's good. So if I'm ready from Rabbi's Beit Midrash. V'chem be'echal, v'chem be'mizbeach. Mishnah says, Nishpach Adam, ad sheglo gamar et matanot shebefnim, right? Yavi dam acher, v'yachazor betchila b'mefnim. So any of the matanot in the Kodesh Kodeshim, if the dam spilt in the middle of a matana, you have to start again from the beginning. Go get more blood and start again from the beginning. You make another shechita. V'chem b'hechal, V'chen b'mizbeach. So each set of dam, you have to complete the dam with the same korban. If you messed up in the middle, go make another shechita and start again. Says the Gemara, Harabanan, v'chiper et mikdash hakodesh. Now this is a pasuk at the end of the avodah. After the whole thing, after the whole avodah, it says like this: v'chiper et mikdash hakodesh. Zulif Naivilifni. Mikdash HaKodesh is the Kodesh Kodashim. I'm looking Rashi. Zelif Naivilifnim. Kiper Bidamim Alalu. He was Mechaper Al Tumah She'iralif Naivilifnim. If there was any Tumah that happened in the Kodesh Kodashim, this was Mechaper. For example, Im Nechnas Adam Sham Betumah. Ve'emba Yedi Abasof. And he didn't find that at the end. So since he didn't find that at the end, he can't bring a Korban. Aval Havaye di Abed Chila, he knew in the beginning. V'alfina mikira'e b'perek kama d'shvot, she'sa'ir ze tole aleha lehagin. That this sa'ir is tole to be megin on the person who needs redeem from suffering, ad she'ivadalo, until he finds out. V'yaviv be'olev yored, and he'll bring a korban olev yored to be mechaper. So v'chiper mikdash ha'kodesh ze lefnai v'lefnim. Ve'et oil moed zehechal. Rashi again. Al tumashi rabbi echal with the same conditions that he knew in the beginning and he didn't find out at the end.
If he didn't know that he was tameh.
I don't know if you realize what Rashi said. He had yediyah techilah, meaning when he became tameh he knew, but he didn't have yediyah basof. What does he mean he never yediyah basof? He never realized afterwards that he went in tameh. Guy became tameh, he forgot. He went to Kodesh Kodeshim. He came out. He still never put two and two together. Yeah, he just doesn't know about it. So this korban is toleh for him until he'll bring a korban. It is. He said, Rashi said, be korban olev yored. When the time will come, he'll bring an olev yored. But right now, he doesn't even know to bring it. So this korban is toleh for him. That's what v'chiper mekdash kodesh. That's if such a tumah happened in the Kodesh Kodeshim. Ve'et ohel moed, that's if such a tumah happened in the echal. Ve'et ha-mizbeach, kemashma'o, Rashi, al tumah, she'ir'a le'adam b'mizbeach, v'shaha, and he waited, he's on the mizbeach, and he had the tumah, v'shaha k'desh ta'havaya, he waited enough time to bow down, she'zeo shi'ur she'ya l'mishin ma ba'azara. If you become tameh in the azara, you're not chayav a korban unless you waited the amount of time that you could have bowed down. But if you went out as soon as you can, it's an onus. There's nothing else for you to do. So they're saying the guy was on the mizbeach and he became tameh and he walked out. So this is again, it's soleh for him.
It's the time to wait.
Ashtahava. Well, 10 seconds, 15 seconds.
There's no time anymore.
He should be mechaper elu azarot. That's the azarot. Meaning, I assume means that is at Israel. Hakohanim kemashma'am. Ama kahal. At the end of the pasuk is ve'al hakohanim. Ve'al mizbeach yichaper. Ve'al hakohanim. Ve'al kol ama kahal yichaper. So the kohanim is kemash. This is the kohanim. Ama kahal elu Yisrael. Yichaper again elu alvim. So we have three places. Four places. You have the Kodesh Kodashim, the Hechal, the Mizbeach, and the Azarot. And for those four places, you have three categories of people. You have the Kohanim, the Israel, and the Levim. The Omit Kaper on Tumad Mikdash Vekadashah. Because that's what the Sa'ir, La Hashem, is Mechaper for. It's Mechaper for Tumat Mikdash Vekadashah. A person that went into the Mikdash without knowledge, or with, by mistake, and didn't know that he made a mistake to bring a Korban. It's Mechaper. This Sa'ir is Mechaper for the Kohanim, Levim, Israelim. On any Tumat Mikdash Vekadashav that doesn't have a Yediyah Basof to bring a Korban, in the Kodesh HaKodeshim, in the Hechal, on the Mizbeach, and in the Azarot. Hu shvu kulan lechapara achat. Shekulam. The kapara achat. Now the Tana Kama continues explaining, Rashi. Hu shvu kulam behayi chaper batra. And the last Yechaper, which we said includes the Leviim, they all included Kohanim, Leviim, Yisraelim. Mechila, my mistake. Ve'ala Kohanim, ve'al kol ha'makahal Yechaper is not going on the Tumat Mikdash ve'kadashav. Why? Look at Rashi. Hushu kulam. Ve'hay Yechaper batra. Kohanim, Levim, Yisraelim, Ahushvu. There's a korban that they all gonna be mitkaper the same. Ubetumat mikdash vekadashav iyevshal lashvotam. You can't tell me that the sa'ir is mechaper for the kohanim on tumat mikdash vekadashav. Sha'arei hapar mechaper al kohanim. Va'sa'ir ana'aseh befnim al Yisrael. Hare the par has the same matan dam like the sa'ir. So the kapara of the par is for the kohen and the kohanim, the same that the matat that the sa'ir does for the levim and the Israelim.
Two separate
kaparot. The kohanim have one kapara for the tumat mikdash v'kadashah with the kohen gadol, and the levim and Israelim are mitchaper with the sa'ir l'Hashem for tumat mikdash v'kadashah. So you can't tell me ve'ala kohanim. Now, kol ama kahal yechaper the levim is all going on to my mikdash v'kadashav. Ubeeze kapara hushvu. So where are they hushvu? Melamed shikulam mitkaprim bevidui shel sa'ir ha'mishtaleach b'shar averot devrei Rabbi Yehuda. Rabbi Yehuda says there is the when are they split? They split legabe the kapara of tumat mikdash v'kadashav. The kohanim use the par of the kohen gadol. And the Levim and Yisraelim are mitkaper with the Sa'ir Lashem. But when it comes to non-Mikdash Averot, which the Kapara is with the Sa'ir Mishtaleach, the Sa'ir Mishtaleach is mechaper for the Kohanim and the Levim and Yisraelim. Everybody's mitkaper over there. Keshu Omer Yechaper. Yechaper. Hushvu kulam lekapara ha, shekulam mitkaprim b'sa'ir mishtaleach b'shar averot, meaning non mikdash v'kadashav averot. Divrei Rabbi Yehuda. Rabbi Shimon Omer, no, he says, kishem shedam ha'sa'ir ana'asa b'fnim, mechaper al Yisrael b'tumat mikdash v'kadashav, just like the dam of the sa'ir of Yom HaKippurim. Is mechaper for Yisrael, f'tumat mikdash v'kadashav. Kach dama par mechaper al kohanim metumad mikdash v'kadashav. Now that Rabbi Yehuda is not arguing on. Or maybe he is. Why? Because he's saying, what's mechaper? What makes the kapara for the Israel? The dam. How do I know that it's the dam that's mechaper? Because there is no vidui on the Sa'ir Ana'asa Bafnim, on the Sa'ir Lashem. It doesn't say that he says a vidui on it. Right?
The Kohanim of everybody.
There's a vidui on the par. There's two viduis on the par. On the Sa'ir Lahashem, there's no vidui. The vidui is on the Sa'ir Ahai, on the Sa'ir Azazil. So Rabbi Shimon says, well, I understand that the Sa'ir Ana'asa Lashem is Mechaper and Tumah Mikdash V'Kadashah. But I see that in order to do that, you don't need a vidui. It's enough just to be mazeh the dam, and that's mechaper on tumah mikdash v'kadashav. The par of Aharon, which is mechaper for the Kohanim, has that same dam, like the Sa'ir, but it also has a vidui. Why does the par of Aharon need a vidui? Not to be mechaper for tumat mikdash v'kadashav, because tumat mikdash v'kadashav is mechaper. You see, bnei Yisrael get it without a vidui. El al korchach, the vidui of the par is keneged the vidui of the sa'ir hamishtaleach. What is the vidui of the sa'ir hamishtaleach mechaper? Not tumat mikdash v'kadashav. It kol avonotam. So too, the vidui of the par is mechaper on the kohen gadol and the kohanim on kol avonotam. So it comes out that the Kohen Gadol and the Kohanim don't have any kapara in the Sa'ir HaMishtaleach. Tumat Mikdash V'Kadashav comes from the Dama Par. Sha'ar Averot of the Kohen and the Kohanim come from the Vidui of the Par. The Yisraelim have a split kapara between the two, Se'irim. The Sa'ir Lashem is Mechaper on the Tumat Mikdash V'Kadashav, and the Vidui of the Sa'ir, Mishtaleach, is Mechaper for Sha'ar Averot. Let's see Rabbi Shimon. Rabbi Shimon Omer, Keshem Shedama Sa'ir Na'asa Befnim. Mechaper al Yisrael b'tuma mekdash v'kadashav, because there's no vidui. Kach dama paru, without a vidui, mechaper al kohanim b'tuma mekdash v'kadashav. Uchshem she vidui shel seir mishtaleach. Just like the vidui of the seir mishtaleach. Mechaper al Yisrael b'shar averot is mechaper for the averot, because there's no matan damim. Kach vidui shel par mechaper al kohanim b'shar averot. Look in Rashi. Rabbi Shimon Omer, Keshem Shedama Seira Na'asa Befni Mechaper Al Yisrael B'tumah Mekdash V'Kadasha Ve'enimu Vidui Kach Dama Par Belo Vidui Mechaper Al Koni B'tumah Mekdash V'Kadasha Ochshem Shevidui Shel Sa'ir Meshtaleach Mechaper V'Shar Averot Kach Vidui Shel Par Mechaper Al Koni U'Bemasechet Shavuot Parchin Ol Rabbi Shimon Havadai Hushvu. What do you do with Yechaper? U'Mshanin An Hushvu D'Bnei Kaparaninu. They compare that they all get a kapara. But each one gets his kapara with his own item. Tanu Rabbanan, another braita. Vechila mechaperet hakodesh. That's pasuk we had before. Vechila mechaperet hakodesh.
It's in, ending it. Finished.
That's right after he finishes the matan damim, right?
Yeah.
All the matan damim. Now he's about to go to the Sa'ir HaMishtaleach. Lazazel. So, V'chila mekaper et HaKodesh, Zeh lefnai v'lefnim. V'et oil moed, Zeh echal. V'et ha-mizbeach, K'mashma od ha-mizbeach ha-zahav. Melamed it teaches, why didn't you say V'chila mekaper otav?
That's right.
What's V'chila mekaper et HaKodesh, V'et oil moed, V'et ha-mizbeach? Because I don't know how to parse up the whole item. Is the whole system that I just described to you one item, or is it separate items? From the fact that it says mikaper et hakodesh ve'et ol moed ve'et hamizbeach, you understand that each segment is an independent standing thing. So that's what he's saying. V'chila mikaper et hakodesh ze lefnai v'lefnim ve'et ol moed ze echal mizbeach kimashma'o melamed shekulan kapara befnei atzman. Each one is a separate kapara. Mikan amru, from here we learned. Natan miktzat matanot shebefnim v'nishpach adam yavid amacher v'yatchil kebatechila. If you did part of the matanot and it stopped, you have to start again from the beginning. Rabbi Eliezer v'Rabbi, and the same for everything else. Rabbi Eliezer v'Rabbi Shimon omrim, enu matchil elim makom shepasak. You stop from where you stopped. Gamar ta matanot shebefnim. If you finish the matanot that were inside. V'nishpach adam, and the blood spilled, yavid ha-maher, this is, v'yatchil, b'tchila b'matanot sheba'echal. So, that's in between, I think everybody agrees with that. Natam miktzat matanot sheba'echal v'nishpach adam, yavid ha-maher, v'yatchil b'tchila b'echal. That's the Tanakama. Rabbi Eliezer v'Rabbi Shimon omrim, enu matchil elu mimakom shepasak. You start from where you were up to. Gamar matanot shebeichal v'nishpach adam.
Are they killing another animal right
yes,
now?
Yes, yes. Yavid amacher v'yatchil. Bring more blood and stop at techila.
B'matanot
ha-mizbeach. You could start from the mizbeach. Natam miktzah matanot shebe'mizbeach. If he started the matanot on the mizbeach v'nishpach adam. Yavid amacher. V'yatchil b'matanot ha-mizbeach. You start the matanot of the mizbeach. Rabbi Eliezer v'Rabbi Shimon omrim, mimakom shepasak u'matchil. Whatever number you're up to on the mizbeach, you start from there. Gamar matanot shebe'mizbeach v'nishpach adam. If you finish the mizbeach matanot and the blood spilled, what's left to do? After you finish the matanot of the mizbeach, what is there left to do? Spill the shiraim on the mizbeach achitzon. Gamar matanot shebe'mizbeach v'nishpach adam, devrei hakol me'akvi. Pouring it on the mizbeach is not me'akiv.
Are we splitting each one of the kaparot based on the hazaot, right?
We're not splitting them. We're saying each one is a separate item.
You know what I'm saying? But like each, the, the tum'ah of the Kodesh Kodashim is mechabel.
Yeah, for sure.
With the haza'ah in the Kodesh Kodashim.
Yes.
So why is it that when you spill it, why is it if you spill it before you get to the mizbeach, why is it that that's all right?
Once you do the kaparot on the mizbeach, everything else is not. I don't know how. The mizbeach achitzon, that's not me'akev. For some reason, that's not me'akev. It's a good question.
What's the story here with this brayta?
The brayta is explaining clearly the machlok between the Rebbe and Shimon and the Chachamim that it's across the board. According to the Chachamim, every segment has to be complete. We'll see more. And if you can't stop in the middle of a segment and then restart with a new korban. Whereas the Rebbe and Rabbi Shimon say, no, every sprinkling is its own item.
You
spilled it, you brought a new korban, continue from number four. Let's see Rashi. V'chila mikaperet ha-kodesh, ze lefnai v'lefnim. Elu hazaot shel ben abadim. Ze hechal hazaot shel ha-parochim. Mikan amru... Lava natan mekzat matanotka. He's not going on the machloket of whether you put some or you put all. El agamar matanot shebefnim. It's going on what we said that if you finish the matanot inside v'nishbach adam, the amar mikam. We learn from here. The entzerich lahazov laasot et zot shegamar. When you bring the new korban, you don't have to. Oh, a new korban has to start from the beginning. No. El share kapara befne atzmai. The kapara and the echal is a separate kapara from the kapara and the kodesh kodeshim. So the Gemara says, Amar Rabbi Yochanan, v'shnehem mikra echad darshu, the Tanakama, and Rabbi Eliezer and Rabbi Shimon, both are learning their yisod, whether you have to do all the hazaot from one korban, or you could break the korban, the hata, the break the hazaot from two different korbanot. They're learning the same pasuk. It says, "Midam hatat hakipurim ahat bashana." V'chiper Aharon al karnotav. It's a ahat bashana midam hatat hakipurim ahat bashana yichaper alav. So what's this ahat bashana? It's extra. The bimeir savar. Hatat echad amarti lecha velo shte hataot. Rabbi Meir says on the Mizbeach midam hatat ha-kipurim ahat. You have to do the hazaot on the Mizbeach from one hatat. Midam hatata kipurim ahat bashana yichaper. So I'm learning midam hatata kipurim ahat. All the hazaot that you're going to do on this mizbeach have to come from one hatata kipurim. But if you spill the blood in the middle of your hatata kipurim and you're going to go shecht another one, that's no good. So start again. So you wind up doing all the hazaot from one hatat. Midam hatata hat amarti lecha v'lo shte hataot. Rashi, hatata hata marti lecha lit kapera kapara ba, v'lo la'asot kapara hat. Don't do the one kapara mishte hata. Rabbi Elazar ben Shimon Safri, chitui echad amarti lecha v'lo shne chituim. Midam hatata kipurim, hatat refers to the sprinkling. Every chitui has to be from one korban. Separate chituim could be from separate korbanot. Rashi. Really? Don't repeat any haza'ah. Every haza'ah that you did, you do once a year. Tanya, Amar Rabbi.
Don't
ever repeat a sprinkling. Hatat ahat. Midam hatat kipurim. Every dam, do only once. Ahat bashana. Ah, you spilled and you... Don't start over. Hatat ahat. One chitui per... The first sprinkling, there's only one first sprinkling. You never have to do it again.
What happened after? After the hazaot.
You did five sprinkles.
Right.
You're missing two. Spill the blood. Hatat ahat. Don't sprinkle again. No. Don't sprinkle the first one again.
So start from the fourth.
Start from Safar, wherever you want.
Yeah, where do you start?
Tanya.
Oh, that, but that's what he was holding before, that you have to start.
The first rabbi holds hatata hat. All the kippurim have to be from one hatat. Yeah. In other words, no hatata hat. Every sprinkling is only one time. Tanya. Amar Rabbi Levi. Amar Rabbi. Li halak Rabbi Yaakov belugin. Li halak Rabbi Yaakov belugin. Rabbi Yaakov told me that the machloki between Rabbi Meir and Rabbi Lezer and Rabbi Shimon does not apply to the log shaman. The log shaman of the Mitzorah, also has to bring. The log, they take his log shaman. And they also sprinkle it in the hechal in front of the paruch seven times, right? And then the kohen goes and he sprinkles it. He puts it on the bohen yadov al bor and aglo. I saw it over there before. I didn't know where it was. We had a similar dirasha before.
But that's for the mixing and it's
completely
different dirasha.
No, Tosfot said it meant the same. Tosfot said it meant the same. Let's go over here. We have Velakah Hakohen et Kevet Hashem veet Log Hashemim veinifo tam tenufa lefnei Hashem veshahat et Kevesh Hashem. ולקח הכהן מדם האשם ונתן על תנוך אוזן המתאר הימני ועבון ידו ועבון רגלו הימני. So the kohen is going to take from the dam and put him on the guy's ears and thumbs. ומן השמן יצוק הכהן על כף הכהן הסמלית ויזה הכהן באצבעו הימנית מן השמן אשר על כפו הסמלית שבע פעמים לפני השם. You know, לפני השם means he goes into the hechal and he stands in front of the kaporet, in front of the parochet, and he does seven times, right? So now those, and then he goes and he says v'natan hakohen min hashemen asher al kapo al tenuch ozen atem ani bon aglo ani yado ani va bon aglo ani al mekom dama asham va notar min hashemen asher al kaf kohen yiten al rosh mitahel lechaper alav levnei hashem. So he does with the shemen three things: seven hazaot in front of the parochet, bohen tenuch bohen and bohen, and the rest of it smear on his head over the mitzvah. Right? So let's see. Let's say the kohen in the middle of the hazaot in the hechal, someone was working on the ketoret next door and he started to sneeze, and all of a sudden, all the shemen out, nothing left. He's up to hazaah number three. Is it the same machloket? Meaning, according to the Bimi Eid, you're going to start again from the beginning. Maybe. I don't know if you're allowed to pour more oil or you have to go get a new oil. And according to the Blaise Rabbi Shimon, just go back and start from number four. So, Li Halak Rabbi Yaakov Belugin. Rashi. Li Halak Rabbi Yaakov Belugin. Li Natan Rabbi Yaakov Hiluk Belog Shamin Shal Mitzora. Shalahushvu Lematan Damim Shal. It doesn't have the same rules as Yom Kippurim. Vishana Li, and he taught me, Lo nechlaku Rabbi Meir v'Rabbi Elazar v'Rabbi Shimon. The machloket is only ba'avodot ha'halukot bo sheva hazaot shebefnim. Umatan behonot lo amrin mimakom shepasak misham umatchil. Over there, we don't say mimakom shepasak umatchil. It's different. Dechtiv v'log echad shamin, one log of shemin, meaning log echad amarti l'chaliot kapara bo. You got to do everything with one log. V'lo shnei logim. And not a second log. Don't start again. The only time you're going to be doresh, ahat b'shana, midam hatat kippurim ahat b'shana, that you only do it once a year. You only make one hitui per don't repeat the Hituyim. Over there, I have a pasuk. Masha'enkin by Loga Shamin, that I don't have such a pasuk. So you have to start again from the beginning. So the Gemara says, Velo, is that true? That Tanya have a braita. Natan miktsad matanot shebifnim. If you did some of the matanot inside v'nishpach halog, and the log was spilt, yavi log aher, bring another log, v'yatchil b'techila, and b'techila b'matanot shebeichal, you got to start from the beginning, from number one. Rabbi Eliezer v'Rabbi Shimon omri, mimakom shepasak u'matchil, same machloket. Gamar matanot shebeichal, if he finished the matanot and the echal, finish bach a log and the log finished. Yavi log aher v'yatchil. You could bring another log and start b'techila b'matanot shebeonot. Start with the thumbs. Natan miktsa matanot b'beonot v'nish bach a log. If some of the thumb stuff stopped, was done, and you spilled the log, he did the tenuch and not the bohen. Yavi log aher v'yatchil b'techila b'matanot shebeonot. Bring another log and start from the ilo. Rabbi Lezer v'Rabbi Shimon omrim, mimakom shepasak u'matchil. They say, no, you did the elob and not the thumb. Start with the thumb. Gamar matanot shebebehonot, if he finished the behonot, v'nishpach halog, divrei hakol, matanot harosh lo me'akevet. The smearing the rest of the oil on his head is not me'akev. So you see, it's exactly the same machloket from Yom HaKippurim by Log Shami. Rashi mikta matanot shebefnim dechtiv yizam in Hashem beitz ba'oshev apamim v'yatchil b'tchila bebeonot shehi avodah shniyah. That's a separate thing. Kedechtiv u'miyeter Hashem asher al kapo yiten ha-kohen matanot ha-rosh v'anotar b'Hashem asher kapo yiten ha-rosh ha-metaher. So you can't say li hilek, he said that the mitzora is different than Yom HaKippurim. Ela Ema, not Ela. Ema, reread Rebbe's statement. Li shana Rabbi Yaakov bilugi. Rabbi Yaakov told me the same machloket by the log shaman. Not li chilek that log shaman is different. Li shana, he told me the same machloket. Rashi, the machloket hazeh shebemishnatenu bilugin shel metzora. Amar mor. Yus, we said matanot harosh en me'akvot. The putting the dam, the shemen on the head of the mitzvah is not me'akev. Ma'ita amar. Why not? Ilema mishum dechtiv. Is it because it says v'anotar min hashemen ela me'ata notar? It's extra. If you have, you have. If you don't have, you don't have. Ela me'ata v'anotar min ha la'aron ubanav kodesh kadashim ishe Hashem. Is it not me'akev to have notar? It's not true. We say that if part of the mincha got lost before the haktara, then you can't be makriv the komets. Look at Rashi. V'ha marmor shirayim shechasru ben kmitza la'aktara em makdirim et ha-komets alay. So you see, v'ha notar is me'akev. Says the Gemara, Shani hatam dechtiv umiyeter vehanotar. By matam behonot, it's the second. It says twice vehanotar. I'm reading the parasha in Balut. In the regular parasha, it says. ומייתר השמן אשר על כפו ייתן הכהן על תנוך אוזן מתאר הימני והנותר בשמן. So first you had יתר and then נותר. יתר went on his תנוך and the נותר of the יתר goes on his head. Look at Rashi. שאני אחד דכתיב ומייתר והנותר מתנות בעונות כלים שריים. What you're putting on his thumbs, that's called שיריים. Matanot Arosh is called Shire Shirayim. It's the leftovers of the leftovers. Dichtiv Behu Vanotar. What's left over from the first leftovers, Yiten Arosh Amitayim. So you can't equate leftovers of leftovers to Vanotar Min HaMinha. Vanotar Min HaMinha. Vanotar Min HaMinha, that's the first leftovers. First leftovers is Me'akev. Leftovers from leftovers. Now, Jack, Fatlat is tasty. Fatlat from the Fatlat. After a while, it stops being so good. Okay. Amar Biyona Yohanan. Asha Mitzora. The Mitzora, he brings in Hashem. That's what we're using all this stuff for. Asha Mitzora. Sheshahato Shelo Lishmo. He made, was shohetet as an ola.
Or, he just never did it.
Banu la machloke Rabbi Meir and Rabbi Elazar ben Rabbi Shimon. The same machloke between Rabbi Meir. If you start again, or Rabbi Elazar ben Shimon that say you continue from where you're up to, the same machloke is going to apply. Look at Rashi. Hashem mitzora shehatan shelo lishma. Kigon l'shem ola o l'shem shelamim. The Amar Mor we said, Kol hazivachim shenishchatu shelo lishman kesherim. Every korban that yishach shelo lishma is kasher except for what's not kasher. Which korban that yishochet shelo lishma is not kasher? Hatat. So Hashem is good. Ella shelo alu lebealim l'shem chova. They don't count for the owner. So now you have an Hashem that's kasher that didn't count for the mitzora. Banu Rashi, banu ledavar ze letoch machloktan shervim v'bishmo. Yes, l'mod, we can learn from them. Shekeshem shahalukim baze ka halukim baze. Like they argue about where you have to restart the matanot from. That's how they're gonna argue about this. How's that? Rabbi Meir de Amar Yavi Acher v'yatchil b'tchila. Who says you start over? Hachanami Yavi Acher v'yishkot. Bring another one and make the shechita. You stop from where you stop. There's nothing to do. I got to stop from where I stop. I can't do anything. Rashi. Let it be me here, Amar Avodah Shelo Nigmera. If I didn't finish the Avodah, it's like you didn't do it. Avze, ho'il velo nigmera, since it's not finished. Why sharelo alta l'shem chova, didn't count for him. Ve'afapi shenatan mimenu lebehonot. Even if he would have started putting on the behonot, because that's the next avodah that you do with the dam of the asham. You have to put it on his thumbs. Harehi kemi she'ena. It doesn't count. Why? Because it's not his. Via via shamacher. Ula rebliyez verbi shimon de amri mi makom she pasak mi shamu matchil. Alma, we don't say kiman deleta damia like it's not there. Achanami hashivahi the shechita counts. I have a shechita. Ve'iv shale gomra be'acher. I can't bring another one. The haketiv keves echad asham. One keves as an asham. How did the word echad is maybe extra? It could have said keves l'asham. What's keves echad asham? Asham echad amarti, do one asham v'lo shte ashamot, and not two. V'hacha leke l'tchuyye kedamrin en le'el chituyye echad amarti. There's no, it doesn't say chituy. You can't say it's saying that don't just start in the middle. They did Hashem, and they say, "Echaz, you know, you do one, don't do it again." Ain't no takana. So this mitzora is stuck. Matkif la Rav Chista. Rav Chista says, "Veha oto ketiv, kashi, kashi. Veha oto ketiv, ekriv oto le Hashem, oto shehunaf imalog, velo acher." The only one that you could bring is the one that you did the tenufa with for the log shemen. According to Rabbi Meir, how are you going to make a takana? You blew it. You made tenufa with the log.
There's no way back.
No way back. Tanya kavated Rabbi Yohanan. We have a braita like Rabbi Yohanan. Hashem mitzora sheshehato shelo lishmo o shenata shelo nata midamo legabe behonot hare ze ola legabe mizbeach. It goes on the mizbeach. V'taon nesachim, you bring the nesachim. V'tzarich Hashem acher lachshiro, you need another Hashem. Now, According to Rabbi Yochanan, the Braita is good. Braita goes like Rabbi Meir, who says, Tzarich Hashem Achir Lach Shiro. And clearly he's not being Doresh or taught to say that you can't do another Hashem. Rav Chista told me that if the Kohen, if they made the Shechita Shelo Lishma, there's no way to fix this Mitzorah. Why? Because you already did the Tinufah on the first Hashem together with the Lokshem. And Oto, one and no others. So what do you mean Tzarich Hashem Achir? You told me that you can't make another Hashem. Says the Gemara, my tzarich, you know what I mean? Tzarich Hashem Acher, tzarich ve'en lo takana. You need one. No, you're not allowed to bring one. Rashi, Tanya kavated Rabbi Yohanan, de'ikel man da'amar yavi acher. L'achshiro, meaning when it says you need another Hashem, l'achshiro, l'mitzora. In order for the mitzora to be able to come to Ha'or, he needs an alechol b'kodashim. Rav Chista says no. Tzarich Hashem Acher. He really needs another Hashem. That I'm sorry, I can't let you bring it, sir. Ein lo takana. Says Gemara, v'tani tana tzarich ve'ein lo takana. Is that a way a tana talks? They say tzarich Hashem Acher, and they expect you to know that there's nothing to do. Says Gemara, in yeah, sometimes they do that. That tanya, like we learned, nazir mimorat, a bold nazir.
A what? Bold?
Bold. Okay. Now, one of the things the Nazir does beyom melot, when he finishes his Nazirut, he shaves his head.
Yeah.
Right? This guy, he's already shaved. Nazir memorat. He's jelly bean bold, right? Bet Shemai Omrim Tzarich Havarat Ta'af. He needs to use the razor. Ubetelel Omrim en tzarich havarata. Betelel says he doesn't need it. Vama Rabbi Abina explained, Kisha Omrim Bet Shammai tzarich, when Bet Shammai says he needs razor, don't think just scraping his head with a razor does anything. Tzarich ve'im lo takana. He needs razor and he can't.
And a what?
He needs a razor, but he can't. Like we said, rubbing the razor on a bald head is not called tiglahat. Rashi, tzarich havarat ha'ar b'yom melot yemidun zok yedichtiv ta'ar lo yavor al rosho ad melot. Aval b'yom melot yigalech betar. Veze en lo se'ar v'katani tzarich. Ve'am Rabbi Abina said tzarich ve'en lo takana. Upliga de Rabbi Pedas. Rabbi Avina's understanding of the Braita that says Sarich ve'en lo takana argues on Rabbi Pedat. The Amar Rabbi Pedat, Bet Shammai, who said Sarich havarata. Rabbi Lazar amru davar echad. They have the same position. Bet Shammai had the Amaran Sarich havarata. Rabbi Lazar, the Tanu Rabbanan, or the Tanan. The Tanan, en lo bohen yad. Regel, you have a mitzvah that doesn't have fingers, doesn't have a thumb. Okay, if you don't have a thumb, so you can't become Tahor. It says,
Vinatan al tenu chol. They put on the plates with the thumbs.
The guy that doesn't have an arm, can you put on tefillin?
Well, you never had a minute of tefillin.
If he doesn't have an arm, can you put on tefillin shel yad?
No.
Oh, he doesn't have a yad, doesn't have. If he doesn't have a head. Right now, so this guy, what do you want? You cannot go through that. If you have a guy that can't go to the mikveh, can he become tahor?
No.
Can't become tahor. He's honest. He's honest. Guy doesn't have a thumb, but he can't do it. That's not a kabbalah. Can't be tahor.
Not in his hand. Nothing. It's not something he did to. Before we're talking all of this, the blood fell, something. It's his fault. I mean, whatever happened.
That's what it's going for.
Whatever it was, his fault. Over here, it's not his fault.
Okay.
Also, the Nazir. He's bald. What should he do? He's bald. From the beginning, it's not higher to
do. Why'd you become a Nazir?
I wish.
Okay. Now. אין לו בוען יד ובוען רגל, אין לו תאר העולמית. רבי אלעזר אומר, נותן על מקומו ויוצא. Put it where it was. So, רבי פדת says that רבי אלעזר that says put it on the place, and בית שמאי that said scrape his head with a razor even though there's no hair is the same. But that's not צריך ואין לו תקנה. So Rabbi Pedat understands Sarich v'yesh lo takana, whereas Rabbi Avina understands Sarich v'en lo takana, because scraping a bald head is not a haircut.
You have hair behind your back.
Rabbi Shimon Omer, Rabbi Shimon says differently. Says normally you need Yeminit. The guy that doesn't have, so his simul is Yemanit. They don't need exactly the way it says. Tana Rabbanan, Vila kach mi dama asham. Right, the Kohen takes from the dama asham, and he puts al tenuch hozenam terem. Right, yachol bekeli. I might say that when he catches the dama asham, he takes it with a keli. Tamud lomar v'natan. It says vila kach v'natan. Maniti na, just like when the Kohen puts the dam on the mitzora be'atzmo shel Kohen, he puts it with his finger. So too when he takes the blood, he has to take it with his body.
They recognize the killer.
What does that mean, a body?
Stick your hand in the bloodstream and catch it.
Okay.
I might say that the Kabbalat Adam of an Asham Mitzora is with his hand also for the Mizbeach, like it is for the Matan Bohen. Tamud lomar ki kahatat asham hu, ahatat and asham are the same. Ma hatat teuna keli. Just like a hatat needs a keli, Rashi. Ma hatat teuna keli le kabbalat dama. De kol korbanot nafkilan behekesha de zot torah la olala min hav la hatav la asham. And by olaba shalomim it says, vayasem ba'aganot. By Moshe Rabbeinu, we call it, ve'asham nami meheched de gamar hatat gamar iu. So therefore, we hutzurach lach zero lechlalo dekahatata asham. Nimtzeta ta omer asham mitzora shene kohanim mekablim et amu. You need two kohanim to catch the blood. Kohen number one, echad biyad for the matan bohen, veechad bekeli for the mizbeach. And he does. Now we leave Mitzora and we go back.
There's two different
receivers.
Two receivers. Each one does his job. Now the Gemara goes back. We had a case where the guy spilled the blood. You had the klotzi kohen gadol hazit. He went out of the kodesh HaKodashim, and he spilled the blood. So then he went and he shechted a second sa'ir, right? Mm-hmm. And then he did the matanot in the hechal, and again he tripped and he spilled the blood. And he went back out and he made a third sa'ir, and he put it on the mizbeach. Now each sa'ir that he shechted,
different step he did.
Did a different part. So they all hashuv. Not only that, but every time he made a se'il Hashem, he made a goral. And he has a se'il Azazel. So I have three dead Se'irim sitting here, and I have three live ones that are Sa'il Azazel. Now, the Pasuk says that when you finish with the Sa'ir, right, when you finish with the Sa'ir, you burn it.
The first one.
Right. Tejayin Kavzayin, it says, ופרה חטאת, ואסעיר החטאת, אשר הובא דמם לחפר בקודש, יוציאו מחוץ למחנה, ושרפו באש את תורותם ואת בשרם ואת פרשם. תנן האטם, וכולם מטמאים בגדים, ונשרפים בבית הדשן, דברי רבי אליעזר ורבי שמעון. רבי אליעזר ורבי שמעון say, all of these פרים,
מטמאים בגדים.
Whoever burns them is mitame begadim, because it says vasorif otam yichabes begadav. Right? V'nisrafim abet adeshen. It should be the opposite. The nisrafim bebet adeshen, and whoever burns them is zoref begadav. So if you had three kohanim burning one sa'ir each, the all metame begadim. That's what we're listening to. Chachamim omrim, en metameim begadim, ve'en nitzrafim abet adeshen ela aharon. Ho'il ve'gamar bo kapara.
Let's go ahead.
What does aharon mean?
The last, the one that finished, the one that you finished the mizbeach one with, that's one. The other one I didn't go to Shkodesh, I know, but you didn't finish the avodah. Hakol olech, ahar agmar. V'chachamim, ba'amine is great. Ba'amine rabba merav Nachman. Kama se'irim meshaleach. How many se'irim does he send? So Mistama, the question is only according to the Belez of Rabbi Shimon.
You would think he would do the last one, because that's the one that...
According to the Tanakama, according to the Belez of Rabbi Shimon, you send away, maybe you would send three, according to the Tanakama anyway, it's only going to be the last one. Shebo, what's it called?
According to Rabbi Shimon, Rabbi Meir...
According to the ones that say that you burn three, maybe you have to send away three. I don't know. The Gemara doesn't say. The Gemara doesn't say that it's talui ze baze. Amar le v'chi edro meshaleach. You want him to send the whole flock?
Need one.
It says, Rashi lo iskika katuv l'shaleach ela echad. Amar lo, he told him back v'chi edro soref. So why does the Rebbe Shimon have him? Having burn all three. Midami hatam lo ketiv oto. Hacha ketiv oto. Over there, but, right, it says, l'shalach oto la'azazel la'midbara. Oto one. Over there, v'apar ha'sair, it doesn't say oto.
So can we learn?